This tutorial demonstrates how to build a 3D printed pneumatic gripper. First, we grind the 3D printed parts. The holes are enlarged to make the tubes fit. The seals are cut using the 3D printed guides. 1 mm thick silicone rubber works the best. A 9 mm blade knife is inserted and then pushed downwards. The seal must stay in place during the cutting process. After cutting, the edges are easily detached. Turn the large seal upside down and place it in the cutting form. We need to cut it in the middle, about halfway deep, to make a folding line. Don't press too deep, as the two halves need to stay connected. The large seal now has an effective folding line. We also make 2 small seals. The edges are slanted, so every seal gets a larger and a smaller face. The larger face is always oriented towards the pressure chamber. It's very important that the dimensions are accurate. The seal height should be around 16.2 or 16.3 mm. The width should be around 10.2 mm for the 2 small seals. Flexible materials are difficult to measure though. The housing is assembled using nuts and bolts. Silicone seals the different parts of the housing. Just enough should be applied to ensure a good seal. Now we apply petroleum jelly, such as vaseline, on the grippers and seals. The largest seal is folded and placed in the bottom cavity. The smaller seals are placed in the top cavity. The larger face of each seal must face the pneumatic tubes. The housing is closed and tightened. The gripper is ready and can be tested. A 5-2-way valve can be used to control the gripper. Yes, it works! There is a bit of leakage due to the 3D printed housing. A well-sealed gripper can be operated with a Lego compressor. The gripper is very effective at crushing soft objects.